Here we go. And three, two.
Another interesting thing about this car is after the 1949 race, the car, Don Lee sold the car to MGM Studios. They were making a movie, the studio was making a movie called To Please a Lady with Barbara Stanwyck and Clark Gable. And this car was used for all the stage and still shots during the production of that movie. They actually took footage from the 1950 Indianapolis race and incorporated it in the movie where the car that was very similar, another KK 2000 car similar to this, was involved in an accident and actually caught fire. And the driver was in the hospital recuperating, and that's when the whole love story happened between Clark Gable and Barbara Stanwyck. This is my wife's favorite car because Clark Gable said it. A lot of cute stories. I took this to Indianapolis one time, and the board, I had the board about the car up on the wheel, and this lady was reading the board. I'm like, I was afraid she was a former English teacher correcting my spelling. She was looking at it, reading it so intently. And she walked around the car and started touching things on the car, and I happened to notice this. Ma'am, you can't do that. I said, Clark Gable sat in that car. She says, I know. She said, she was totally taken up with this car because of Clark Gable. So anyway, we were visiting for just a few brief minutes, and I said, would you like to sit in it? And I thought the lady was absolutely going to faint right in front of me. And luckily enough, her husband was there with her. She got in the car, and they took pictures, and I'm sure I made the lady's day. But it's a beautiful car, a lot of history. After the movie, they used it in the movie. It was sold to a racer by the name of Joe Gimsa. And ironically, he put a fellow in it by the name of Bud Rhodes that I alluded to earlier about protesting one of my dad's cars. And they actually won a 500-mile oval race at the Riverside International Raceway, because at one time there was an oval incorporated for the road course. So it's a very special car, got a lot of history. You'll notice it in the movie if somebody ever takes the time to look at it. It's known as the Mike Brennan Special, and it's number 17. And it's an eye catcher. I've had this in Goodwood in 2001. Again, it's an eye catcher. Sounds really great when it's running, and I truly enjoy driving it when I get the opportunity to do that. And with that, we'll go on to the 1952 Myron Stevens car.
Cut.